Hello, and welcome to a brand new Let's Play, Her Story. Blind, of course. I'm the RPG Chick, and this is a game you could find on GOG and Steam for $6. And it's a really short game. I'm anticipating 4, 5, 6 the most episodes. Maybe even less, I don't even know. So I'm playing this blind, I've never played this before. I've watched, like, there's little video, like, vignettes you watch throughout, and I've watched, like, 8 of those, and, like, okay, I understand how the game works enough so it's not frustrating for you guys to watch. So other than that, let's begin. So this lady... You have all these interviews of her. She's a suspect in a murder case. And, did she commit the murder? Or not? And why? What's the motive? You know, and if she didn't kill him, who did? So, I kind of think this is neat, the way this is set up with the glare like this. You're basically looking at an old-style monitor. And I think this takes place in the 90s. This looks like Windows 3.1 or something. So I hope you guys don't mind. I'm going to turn off this glare. Of course, it looks kind of cheap this way. But you can see better. So anyway, subtitles are on, of course. You are logged in. Enter query to access archive footage. Query history. Okay, that's your history. Empty. I can move this. You can look. Southeast Constabulary. Now, what's funny is that, well, the clock shows the current time, but... Or... That's actually not the time I'm playing this game. But it says we're in 2017 here. Which is June 16th. That's not the date either. So if we hit log off, this ends the game, so you don't want to do that. And hitting X here does the same thing. We got readme. Introduction to the logic database. Now I read all the things, so I'm assuming there's going to be other things to read except for these two readmes. So if you don't like people who read all the things, sorry, maybe check another Let's Play. There's quite a few out there of this game, I believe. Anyway, about the logic database. Computer technology is the backbone of modern police work. The logic database is one of the many continuing efforts to digitize our workflow. This is the English spelling of digitize. And preserve evidence in a manner which will allow you to work more efficiently. In the coming years, the computer will continue to be the most valuable item in your crime-fighting toolkit. This database contains footage transferred from the existing homicide and serious crime tape archive at Portsmouth. It has been automatically sorted using our ASR technology. I'm not sure what that is. Advanced search recognition? Automatic search recognition? Each statement made by the interview participants is stored separately, so they can be tagged for submission to court. The audio has been digitally stenographed, and the content of the testimony is attached to each clip. To retrieve a clip, type in a word, such as robbery, into the search field. Click search, and the database will return all clips in which the speaker uses that word. To narrow a search, use multiple words, robbery supermarket, such as if you are working from a printed transcript. Transcript can be even more precise. Use inverted commas to search for an exact match against the entire statement. E.g., yes, I was there. Inverted commas. These are quotes. And that's a comma, but it's not inverted, so I'm not sure. But yeah, that's the format, so we need to know, right? To store a clip for later reference, click Add to Session. Also, if you wish to add additional tags of your own to help future searches, please click in the User Tags box and type in your desired tags. That's pretty neat. For any further assistance, please contact your department's Information Technology Representative. Police Information Technology Organization. PITO. Yay. Hooray for PITO. Really read me. Hey, here's the database. I filed a Freedom of Information form to get you guest access, which is guest access. Everything seems to work. They transferred the videos off the original tapes in 1999, and then the Y2K thing hit and they got mothballed. No one has touched them since. I couldn't find the server with the detective's footage on. Possibly those tapes got damaged when the old archives were flooded in 97, but figured this would be enough. Take your time. SB. Whoever the hell SB is, so... I'm not completely sure when this takes place. Maybe it does take place in 2017 and we're reopening the case. Maybe someone's bucking for a promotion. I don't know. And the rubbish bin... I forgot this mirror game. I don't really understand how it works. By HSoft, but all this looks like really 90s stuff. So this is a hack thing that someone hacked the game, or cracked it, rather. One for the mums here. Classic two-player strategy for lunchtime gaming. Enjoy. And I'm not sure who that's supposed to be. Cracks with class. So it's the mirror game. There's no instructions. Player one's turn. So red goes... So we want to move it... there. And I guess we completed the row. Player two, which I'm guessing is purple, but is blue here. We can... Yeah, I don't know how it works. So eventually you fill up the board and whoever has the most tiles, I'm just clicking anything here. In the screen wins, or on the board rather. I'm just trying to go fast, so... I don't know why I feel like just doing this. Dun, dun, dun. What do you guys think of the background music? I like it. It's very, like, mysterious and sleuthy sounding. Hooray! Whatever! Okay. So that's it. That's all the... Oh, wait. We've got this database checker. And I don't... I'm not sure... I guess that comes into play later. Anyway, so we've already got murder filled in. So we go search. And here she is. We've got these little interviews. Now we can add to session, which puts it down there. And you can move those around. Like you can go add to session, add to session. Add a session and say you think these two are first. You can put these here. I don't even know. See, I can barely see the tag there. I can't seem to move this one in the middle. There you go. Anyway, and you can add your own tags, like it says. Let's see what she has to say.
You think it's murder? I mean, clearly it's murder.
Well, clearly.
What can I do to help?
Confess your crimes, wench. And... Sorry, random throat noise. Starbucks.
Yeah? That's me. But... February, and that was months ago. What's that got to do with Simon's murder?
So February, she says, but this was recorded on January 7th. So, yeah, it was technically months ago, but wouldn't she say almost a year ago? We've got these white shirt ones, so obviously these are different days, and this is the same days as each other here.
I didn't murder Simon.
March.
You've got it wrong. You've got the wrong person.
Right. So back in 94.
I'd like to speak to a lawyer now. Please. You have no murder weapon. You have nothing. And all these stories we've been telling each other. Just that. Stories.
Let me tell you a story. So this is March 7th, 94. Wait, hold on. I got myself screwed up with this. June of 94. January. Alright, so June... See, it is difficult moving them around. So I don't know if I'm gonna sort them all like this guy is, of course. We got January, June. This is gonna be July then. 12:05. 11. So that's the order there. So we don't even know what her name is, though. I like how it's MPEG.
Yeah, that's me.
Can you fast forward?
February? That was months ago. What's that got to do with Simon's murder?
Right, so his name's Simon. So let's search for Simon. And I put a... I know we got it anyway. So these are all... Now, 61 entries found. Access limited to first 5 entries. What? Who made the software? This is incompetence. So naturally, it's gonna be... all or mostly Simon. So I'm going to narrow it down even further. Let's watch these. And this took place in June of 94. Right, which is... June 27th. And this is June 6th. That puts it to the end. I hate that. I was going to add everything. I mean, maybe off screen I'll put them all in a row at some point. Okay. So let's watch this one.
Simon Smith.
His
brother's glass. They do windows, all kinds of glass.
Write this down.
Simon does the more special work. Mirror making, feature windows. Artistic things. Really beautiful things.
Okay, so we got Ernst Brothers Glass.
Simon is 6 foot, darkish blonde hair, average build. He's clean shaven. If his beard grows, it goes ginger, so he shaves it. I mean, not that there's anything wrong with ginger hair. I bought a photo. They said a spring photo. This was taken last year on holiday in Rome.
Rome.
It's the best one I have.
Now, they said there's things attached to these, but I guess maybe not these. I don't even know. Documents and such that you can read, but I guess not on these.
It's the Rockington Arms, the Rock. It's run by a nice couple, Peter and Susan. There's some other regulars there that Sam likes to drink with, and the barmaid they're having sometimes, Helen. Peter said Simon had been in and had a few drinks.
She looked down when she said Helen. You notice that?
Yes. There's an Amstrad one. No one uses it for very much. There's a printer so you can write letters on it. Simon sometimes plays games. You know, climb the tower, save the princess. That kind of thing.
Climb the tower, save the princess. King's Quest?
Simon isn't the type to run off or do anything crazy. Someone must have done something to him, or there must have been some kind of accident. So what do we do next?
I guess I'll find that out. This is probably a nothing, so I just want to look at it. Just got that ginger, and that's the one we've already viewed, so she doesn't say anything else about ginger. So what about this bar, which is Rockington Arms, I believe. Okay. Bar. Okay, so I'm guessing this is a different bar. So this Rockington Arms, unless I spelled it wrong. Oh wait, I'm crossing out things that I didn't look at. And we already looked at Simon. So let's check out this one.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
What would you be doing in Oxford if there was no conference?
Oxford.
I remember calling him. He said it was boring and he spent most of the time at the bar.
So this is just every time she talks about a bar. Not Rockington Arms specifically.
So I moved out. Got a small bed set. Got my tattoo to mark the occasion. I was singing in the bar in the evenings. So I had some money, enough money to cover my rent. And I've been doing something similar ever since. I haven't put down any roots. I don't exist.
Oh, you exist, all right. We're definitely aware of you. So she's a singer.
He saw me singing one of my shows. Pure chance. Not sure I remember what he was even doing there. Afterwards, I had a drink at the bar and he came over and we got talking. I knew who he was. Obviously I knew who he was. But he didn't know who I was. He was fascinated by the likeness. He guessed my name from my tattoo.
Okay.
Told me it was a palindrome, but that would impress me. I enjoyed talking to him. It was amazing to be able to sit and interact and talk to him after all this time. He didn't tell me he was married. I'm not sure what he was thinking. He later told me it was like he was dreaming. A waking dream.
So, I'm not sure if she's talking about Simon. It looks as if she's talking about Simon. I mean, obviously, she had already broken up with Simon, I'm guessing. Because she already had the tattoo, which she got right after the breakup. And she went to singing and, she basically lived alone and stuff and took it easy kind of thing, and she didn't exist, blah blah blah. But then she runs into Simon, and he doesn't think it's her, but he thinks, wow, you look just like whoever this is. Her name. I don't even know her name. So he's thinking that she's a lookalike. Which is weird. I guess she had a different hairstyle. I don't know. Maybe he was drunk and he thought, I don't know. She didn't say he was drunk. Kind of weird though, that he wouldn't guess it's her. So I'm not sure what that's about. It was a long one.
Nothing else happened that night. We talked, then I said goodbye. Then next week I was seen in the bar again, and there he was. And again the next week, he offered to buy me a meal. I told them I had already eaten, and so we got chips and ate them on the beach instead. When we said goodbye, he asked me to kiss him. Romantic.
So more of that story. Which I'm guessing that's Simon. I wish she used a name there.
No. I told her it was one of my boyfriends. Someone I had met in the bar. I think she was happy. But I could tell she was thinking, why couldn't it happen to her and Simon? They were the ones with the real life. Why not them?
Okay. So is she not talking about Simon? Because this whoever she's talking about... I'm kind of confused. I don't know if she's talking about Simon, and this girl was with Simon, or wants to be with Simon. Confusing. Okay, let me ask her about this tattoo, or see if there's anything about the tattoo. Okay, two we've already seen, and then there's this one. Or these two.
No, he doesn't have any tattoos.
He
has a scar. Down here, near his stomach, past his hip. Cut himself with some glass. That was before, a long time ago. He looks just like the photo. He's not got his glasses on here, though. He takes them off for the camera. But he needs them to see properly, you know. He needs to read.
Oh.
A newspaper or a menu in a restaurant. Not books so much, or watching TV.
Maybe he didn't have his glasses on when he saw her in the club, or the bar, rather. Yes, let's see the tattoo. I want to see this thing. Show us the goods.
Oh, my tattoo.
Oh, now you can see it because of your sweat suits.
I got it to express my individuality.
Mm-hmm.
It's an apple and a snake.
An apple and a snake. Is there anything to that? No. I'm just searching for obscure things first, just to eliminate them, guys. Yeah, apple snake. Okay. About, anything else about Peter? Nope. Susan, these are the people that own the Rockington Arms. And then the barmaid is named Helen. And she kind of looked down when she said that. Here's another one, Helen. Okay. Short one.
No. I think he spoke to Helen. She said he was upset about her argument, but I'm not sure what else he said. He likes Helen. He likes blondes.
Mm-hmm. So she doesn't really like that very much, but there's nothing else about Helen. What about Rome? You'll always have Rome. Oh, there's nothing else. Okay. Ernst Brothers Glass. Nothing else there. Oh, she mentioned Amstrad, which is an old computer. Nothing. Alright, that's my whole first sheet. So, we've asked about the tattoo. It's got a scar. He wears glasses. Oh my. Six entries found, but we can only see... It's too bad he didn't limit access and take out one of these. Or two of those. This is a different... This is from June 25th of 94.
He wasn't a present so much. It was one of those arguments that had been simmering for a while. The present was a mirror. A nice mirror. He'd engraved the glass, the kind of mirror a princess would have in a story. He made it specially for me.
Oh, she's mentioning princess again. I'm gonna write that down. I have a series of, like, post-its here. So that's glasses, but different kinds of glass.
His body. Didn't look real.
Didn't look real?
His throat. It looked like his throat had been cut.
Well, she found the body?
And I didn't see his glasses. As these thick glasses.
She's mentioned that. He doesn't always wear them. Some June 30th is later.
Look, on his clothes, that would make sense. He made it. By hand. I mean, he brushes the silver onto the glass. That's not how they make mirrors these days. I mean, he made the mirror. He gave it to me.
The mirror is obviously very important to her. So she talks any more about this mirror. 11 entries found. She really talks about this mirror. Let's play this one.
My name is Hannah.
Hannah.
H-A-N-N-A-H.
Good. No name.
It reads the same backwards as forwards.
Oh.
It doesn't work for mirror, though. It's not quite symmetrical, but, well, I mean, you get the idea. Sorry. Hannah Smith. I live at 31 Gladstone Street.
Okay. Now, that's interesting. I thought whoever was in the bar... As you can see, I'm not adding to session. It's going to be ridiculous to have so many files just hanging out there. What was I saying? She's talking about the tattoo. He showed her that... She showed him the tattoo, and he said it was a palindrome. I'm just going to watch these, and I'm going to go back and look at that video. Because I thought the tattoo was a palindrome. But that's a picture of a snake and an apple.
The mirror. I can't remember. I put it somewhere safe.
Well, where'd she put the mirror?
Upstairs, I think. I haven't looked at it since.
Is that 14 seconds? It didn't seem 14 seconds. I wish we had, you know, the questions. We only have the answers.
Silverleaf? No. He normally silvers them properly. This mirror, it's supposed to look antique. the reflection isn't as good. Mm. It's the perfect mirror for someone who doesn't like to look at their own reflection.
So they found the mirror. June 30th. Somewhere between June 27th and June 30th. Well, either that or they might have had the mirror the whole time and just asking her where she left it. And now it revealed on the 30th, here's the mirror. Okay. Let's talk about Princess a couple times. Seven entries found. Oh, didn't I want to look up something else? Oh, wait. I'm going back to Princess. Palindrome. Which is the old one? This one, right? Oh, I can skip ahead.
He saw me singing and came over. He was fascinated by the likeness. He guessed my name from my tattoo. Told me it was a palindrome, right, that would impress me. I enjoyed talking to him. It was amazing to be able to, right, that would impress me.
It's a tattoo of a snake and an apple. How would he guess her name from the tattoo? That at least tells me that she's not talking about Simon. Okay, anyway, Princess. We have a few entries. Like, still too much to fill in here.
Let me see. Yes. I drove in here because I remember, well, I went over the river. And then there was a church. There. Yeah. And I probably parked. Well, I remember seeing a street sign called Princess Street. Yeah, there it is. Yeah, so I'm pretty sure it must be this one. There.
That's Princes, not Princess, which of course... It's picking up all the letters except, you know, that this is enough to... With the S missing, it's Princess. I don't know how to explain it. Okay, so... Princess Street, River, Church.
Yeah, we were 17. It was a nice wedding, people said. Simon looked very handsome in the photos. His parents paid for everything, but he's an only child, so it was important to them. It was what they called a shotgun wedding, but if you looked at the photos, you couldn't tell. The dress was beautiful. It looked like Princess Diana's. The train wasn't quite as long, though. There's a great photo of the bridesmaid helping to carry it out of the car.
So, she has or had a kid. Interesting. Back in March?
We were obsessed with fairy tales. Not just the pretty, pretty ones, but the traditional ones. They were dark and real, bizarre and violent. Mm. Felt like life. We had this huge old book that I think Mum must have bought from a library sale. The illustrations had thin tracing paper over them to protect them. They were in colour, shiny plates. At the front of the book was an index of illustrations. We read that more than the actual stories. We'd read aloud the captions and flip between the pictures. There was something intimate about peeling back the tracing paper and dressing the pictures. Rapunzel's hair is cut. The eagle plucks out his heart. The princess pricks her finger.
Hmm. Okay. Too bad we don't know the name of that book. Okay. Tell me more about the wedding, then. There were 17.
I guess you could call it that, but we were both happy to get married. It was a beautiful wedding. We had our first dance to Come Back and Stay. I'm not sure if that's a good wedding song, but I loved it. I chose it. I mean, it was genuinely our first dance. We'd never danced together before. It was probably awful to watch, but I enjoyed it. Good wedding song, but I loved it. Come Back and Stay. I'm not sure if that's a good wedding song, but
Come Back
I
and
loved
Stay,
it.
Huh?
I chose it before. It was probably awful to watch, but I enjoyed it. It felt like it was just me and Simon for that moment. Just the two of us.
Okay, so we've got the name of the song I wrote down.
We spent the wedding night in a hotel in Brighton.
Right.
It would have been too much to do more. We were staying for the baby. It was wonderful to be in a hotel, away from home, just alone together. Since then, we've always tried to get away for our holiday.
Okay.
Yeah, that's Simon's watch. It was a gift from Eric.
Eric.
He got it this year. It was a wedding anniversary gift. Steel.
Who's Eric?
It would have been Diane who chose it. She has really nice taste.
Who's Diane?
That time. You must eliminate me. I was in Glasgow then.
Glasgow. Okay, I've got a lot of search terms here. Good thing I'm writing them down, because I would never remember all this. This is a long one, almost 2 minutes.
No.
Yes, it is.
The parents decided there would be a wedding. And after the wedding, Hannah moved in with his parents. There was no way I could follow, so we were separated again.
I thought your name was Hannah.
I stayed in the attic. It was hard. It's like I suddenly didn't exist. I would sneak out, but in case anyone recognized me, I started wearing a wig.
The hell?
Hannah and I would meet up in the park. I was trying to get pregnant. But I couldn't. I mean, I couldn't do it with anyone we knew, so it was sex with strangers. Drunk guys I'd met in clubs. Parks and alleyways. I was 17.
The kid's not his.
I felt like I was being punished.
But I thought her name's Hannah.
But it was Hannah who had betrayed us. I stopped when one of the guys gave me an STD. When we met up, it was disturbing. For the first time, my reflection, she didn't look like me. She was fatter, flushed.
She...
If anything, I was getting skinnier. Had a hearty look sometimes.
She has multiple personalities.
We talked about what to do. Was it time to become our own people? I mean, that seemed like the right thing to do, but neither of us wanted it. We agreed that her and Simon would get their own place as soon as possible, and then I could move in. And that was the plan.
Ah. Oh, we got music playing, because this is significant. Multiple personality disorder, also known as dissociative identity disorder.